Today, I'm going to take you on an exciting but a little bit long journey through the hiring process at Turing, the platform that connects talented developers like yourself with some of the biggest names in Silicon Valley. Now, if you've ever dreamed of landing a job with a top-tier Silicon Valley startup or a leading tech company like OpenAI, you've clicked on the right video because in this video series, I'll be walking you through the entire process, starting from the sign-up and uploading your resume to nailing that final interview. To prepare for this, I have spoken to multiple developers, including one who's working with OpenAI, and all of these people have successfully gotten jobs through Turing, and they have shared some golden nuggets of wisdom that I'll be passing on to you. Trust me, you don't want to miss this. Right, let's kick things off with the first step, which is signing up on Turing's platform. Head over to Turing's website and click on the login and then for developers button. From here, if you already created an account in the past, just log in or click on create account to sign up if you're going there for the first time. In the second step, you will be asked to upload your resume. You can skip this step as you can see over here, but that is going to bring a lot of pain for you in the next step. I'll show you why, but before that, quick tip. When you're uploading your resume, make sure that it's tailored to highlight your skills and experiences which are relevant to the tech roles that you're aiming for. This can significantly boost your chances of getting noticed and for Turing's HR to find the right match for you. Now, if you're finding this video helpful so far, make sure to hit that like button. Your support helps me bring more valuable content to you. Now, in the third step, you are required to complete your profile. This is where you provide information like your education, experiences, skill set, current salary, expected salary, etc. And if you upload your resume in step number two, as I suggested, many of these fields would be automatically filled in for you. So make sure to not skip that step. Now, all of this that we've discussed so far takes about 5 to 10 minutes to complete. And after that come the assessments which are related to the job openings you will be applying for, like data engineer, front-end developer, full-stack developer, etc. You need to remember that the initial assessments are absolutely crucial. They test your core skills in the tech stack that you preferred. So take your time and practice beforehand. To help you with that, I actually signed up on Turing and took some of these assessments, and in the next video, I will show you what's in them, what their difficulty level is like, and how you can prepare for those assessments. You can see the video right now either on the left or the right bottom of the screen. See you in the next video.